shotgun now for Brady. Wide open receiver complete. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. On first down, Brady. Completion left side to Miller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Throwing on first down is Brady. And Miller with it over the middle. A gain of 6 there on first. So the offense readies for a 2nd and 4. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in the cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering what's going to go good or bad for your team.
Got a man. He finds Sanders. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Emmanuel Sanders, 43 yards. And the Patriots are back within a score.
Big score. First step in their attempt to climb back into this game.
Yes, but still some work to do as they get within a score here. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down. The 4th quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
On 2nd down, it's Bell. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
But it was stopped on that play. We've had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to them the rest of the game.
On 3rd down, Roethlisberger. And he's got Rodgers. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. And the defense in desperate need of a stop. They have to get off the field and get the ball back to their offense if they want a chance.
And that pickup of a 1st down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Now a 1st down carry by Bell. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. 2nd down, offense behind the sticks here. 2nd and 13. Again, it's Bell. And he went backwards. Now whistles blow, and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. On 3rd down, here's Bell. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their 3rd and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Boy, he fielded it right on the goal line. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the pass will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. The Steelers defense, we watch them get set to go. They've got a situation where a field goal ties it. How do you defend this? Because you obviously don't want to give up the touchdown. How aggressive do you get?
That's always the key, isn't it? Where is the line on aggressiveness to over-aggressiveness? And I think most coordinators are looking at it like, what are your regular defense? Add some pressure packages, because really the 35-yard line is the one you really want to defend. At that point, you're thinking you're probably giving up three. Anything outside of that, you feel like you've got a chance to hold them.
So they'll be in search of the proper amount of pressure. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Back to throw. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. They'll get 19 yards there, and it'll give the Patriots a first down. He's back to throw. Left side here to Sanders. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They'll look to throw. Surveying the field. Flushed out right. And Edelman finally works his way open. It's complete. A very solid gain of 27. And now they're in the hurry up. He'll look to throw. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it's a second down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Back to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. To throw is Brady. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute. So with next to nothing left on the clock, they get Charles what should be the game-winning touchdown catch.
That felt so much like practice and preparation coming together. So many times, your last practice of the week, you score the game-winning touchdown. Everyone leaves the field feeling good about themselves. They got it done for real in this situation.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Oh, look at the juke. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The New England defense gearing up to take the field. And they're just trying to keep him out of the end zone. Obviously, a field goal does no good in this situation. So what's the appropriate amount of pressure defensively, Charles?
I think he's had a little more pressure than what is normal. If you normally want to send a 3-man rush, maybe you make it 4. If it's 4, maybe you make it 5. Anything to make sure that he can't just sit back there all day and find a target. And then you tell your secondary, play your normal coverage and maybe an extra step or 2 back.
Yeah, be careful that nothing goes over the top. 1 receiver left, 3 to the right. Now it's Roethlisberger. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Night Train Lane. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to come up just short as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. They go with a duel again. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. A great come-from-behind victory in this one, Charles. And really, the difference, obviously, was that fourth quarter. They dominated.
And it has to start. Hey, you never had you had this. Why are you still?